Good morning, children. In the last video, I have shown the dissection of hibiscus flower showing the floral parts. There was an activity given for you. Hope all of you have done. Have you done yourself? All of you have to do the dissection of different flowers available in your locality. Then only you will be able to understand the parts of the flower in real. Today's topic is sexual reproduction in plants. I have already told you, flower, fruits and seeds are the reproductive parts of a plant. Whereas roots, stem, leaves are asexual parts. Are you remembering? A flower changes into a fruit after two processes. One is pollination and the second one fertilization. Pollination, then fertilization. So if the flower undergoes these two processes, pollination and fertilization, then only the flower can change into a fruit. So what is pollination? You have learned in smaller classes in very brief. Today we are going to learn in detail. What is pollination? Pollination is the transfer of pollen grains from anther to the stigma. This is a stamen. This is the filament, as I have already told you in the last video. And this is the knob-like part, anther. Inside the anther, pollen grains are formed. On maturation of the anther, releases pollen. These powdery pollen are the male gamete or male reproductive cell. Pollination is the transfer of pollen grains from anther to the stigma. On maturation of anther, pollen grains are released out. These yellow color pollens, so the transfer of pollen grains from anther to the stigma, that is stamen to the pistil. Or in other words, you can say the transfer of pollen grains from the male reproductive organ to the female reproductive organ is known as pollination. So the transfer of pollen grain, that is what pollination means. The pollination is possible with the help of agents. Agents of pollination. Agents of pollination means the factors which are involved in the transfer of pollen grains from the male reproductive organ to the female reproductive organs. If the factors are living, they are called biotic agents, like insects, birds and other animals. Even you also can be an agent of pollination. Abiotic agents of pollination means the non-living factors like air, water, etc. So the pollination is done by biotic or abiotic agents of pollination. Why agents are required? Plants are fixed to their place. Plants are stationary. So they can't do this work without the help of an external agent. That is why external agents are nominated by the nature for this particular work. There are two types of pollination: self-pollination and cross-pollination. In self-pollination, the pollination occurs between the flowers of the same plant. You can see a plant is producing many flowers. So if the pollen grains are transferred from one flower to the other flower of the same plant, it is called self-pollination. In the case of bisexual flowers, we have learned it in the last video. In bisexual flowers, what is the meaning of that? Both the reproductive organs, that is the male and the female reproductive organs, stamens and pistil, both are present in the same flower. Suppose this is a bisexual flower. So the male reproductive organs, stamens are also there and pistil is also there. In the same flower, if the pollen grains transfer from the anther to the stigma of the same flower, then also it is called self-pollination. This is the butterfly. The butterfly is settled over the flower. The purpose is to take nectar. So meanwhile, unknowingly, it is carrying the pollen grain on its feet. And if this visits, the butterfly visits another flower of the same plant, this is self-pollination. From one flower to the other flower of the same plant. So while sitting on the other flower, the pollen grains can be dropped on the stigma of the flower. So here the transfer of pollen grain from one flower to the other flower of the same plant. So this is self-pollination. Then what is the other chance? The flower has to be bisexual. That is, both male and female organs are in the same plant. So there also, if the same flowers anther, the butterfly is collecting the pollen grains and settling over the stigma of the same flower. So pollination is occurring in the same flower itself. So that is also self-pollination. So I repeat, self-pollination means the pollen grain transfer from the anther to the stigma of the same flower, or from one flower to another flower of the same plant. Remember, self-pollination occurs only in bisexual plants. Either the flower has to be bisexual, or some plants are there like mango plant which has unisexual flowers. That is, male flowers are also there in the mango plant. So the flower is unisexual, but the plant as a whole is bisexual, isn't it? So in that case also, the plant is considered as a bisexual plant, even though the flowers are unisexual. So in mango plant also, self-pollination is possible. Okay, so self-pollination occurs in a bisexual plant only. Now, cross-pollination. In cross-pollination, the pollen grains are transferred from one plant to another plant of the same species. Imagine this is one plant, this is another plant of the same species. Here, the agent of pollination, I am showing here a butterfly, which is a biotic agent of pollination. The pollen grains are transferred by these butterflies from this flower to the flower of another plant. But remember, both the plants belong to one species. Suppose the pollen grains of a hibiscus flower is carried to a rose flower. Both of them belong to two different species. Pollen grains sense the juice at the stigma and it dries and fall off. It cannot go for the further growth. So that is the difference. If pollen grains are carried by the agent of pollination from one plant to another, it will lead to pollination only if both the plants are belonging to one species. But you know that in a garden, so many plants are there, all do not belong to same species. So this way, many pollen grains are wasted. So this is a rule of the nature to control the population of the plants. So in cross-pollination, you have seen the pollen grains are transferred from the anther to the stigma of one plant to another plant. Both the plants belong to one species. Now you may be thinking, the cross-pollination, when I am talking about from one plant to the another, does it mean that from a male plant to the female plant? It can be. For example, suppose this is a unisexual plant. Suppose this is a staminated plant, that is male plant. That is, all the flowers are male flowers. And imagine this is a female plant which has all the flowers female, that is pistillated flowers. So in that case, the pollen grains are transferred from the male plant to the female plant, that is from the male flower to the female flower. So this is also an example of cross-pollination. It doesn't mean that cross-pollination occurs only in unisexual plants. It can be in bisexual plants, that is hermaphrodites. So let's see that. Now look at the sacred tulsi plant or basil plant. This plant is a bisexual plant, that is a hermaphrodite. In basil flower you can see the stamens and the pistil, that is it's a bisexual flower. And so naturally in the same flower itself pollination is possible. But suppose these tulsi plant, the pollen grains are transferred by the bees to another tulsi plant, then it is cross pollination, isn't it? So in a bisexual plant, self pollination as well as cross pollination possible. Whereas in unisexual plants, only cross pollination possible. That's all about pollination. Most of the plants possess bisexual flowers. You know that flowers are the reproductive part of an angiosperm plant. So bisexual flowers means the same flower has stamens and pistils, that is male part and female parts are present in the same flower. Most of the plants are belonging to this category. They bear the flowers which are bisexual. Examples: hibiscus, mustard, tulsi, that is basil, guava, etc. But some plants possess only male flowers, that is staminated flowers. We call them purely male plants. Their female plants are separate. Their female plants possess only pistillated or carpellated flowers, that is exclusively female flowers are seen in such plants. For example, mulberry. Mulberry, male plant and female plants are two different plants. Male mulberry plant bears only male flowers. Female mulberry plant bears only female flowers. Another example for such unisexual plants are date palm, khajur ka ped. Now the third category, like coconut. Same coconut plant has male flowers as well as female flowers. So the flower is unisexual, but the plant is bisexual. Understand the difference? In the case of mango plant, it has unisexual flowers as well as bisexual flowers in the same plant. The unisexual flowers which are present in the mango plant are all male flowers. And the other category, bisexual flowers. So the same mango plant has male flowers and bisexual flowers. So here also the plant is bisexual, and some flowers are bisexual, some mango flowers are bisexual and some mango flowers are unisexual, but there is no female flower separately seen in the mango plant. So this is how the plants are classified based on their gender. The flowers can be unisexual or bisexual. Like that, the plants also can be unisexual, as in the case of mulberry and dates, or bisexual in two different cases you have seen, in the case of mango plant and in the case of hibiscus, mustard. But there are some differences, as I told.